is the class name? Name of the class? 9 got over. Tanna also got. Backside people go still some more back. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's very simple. Select a command should be triggered through execute query method. Yesterday we have used only execute method. Execute query you have to use while supplying a select command. While sending a select command, use execute query. It returns all the results into results set. Whatever select command is returning, all are returning to the result set. Result set containing all the records whichever returning by SQL command, select command, result set. Inside a result set, there is a cursor concept. That cursor will be before first row. Initially, result set cursor will be before first row. While calling rs.next, cursor will come to the first row. If first row available, it returns a true. If first row available, it returns a true. If it is returning a true, control will go inside a while loop, reading ID column, reading name column, reading age column, then print it. Now cursor is at first row. Going to the next iteration, calling next method once again. While calling next method, cursor will go to the second row. If row is available, if at all row is available, it returns a true. If row is available, returning a true. If it is returning a true, control will go inside reading ID, reading name, reading age, then new line. Is what we have done. Then going to the rs.next. Third row. While calling next method, going to the next row, checking whether row is there or not. If row is there, returning true. If row is there, returning true. If it is true, going inside a body, get ID, get name, get age, then new line. Again rs.next. As long as rows available in the results, while loop will continue. While covering loops, I told very clearly, while loop is more convenient while iterating iterations through method return statement. While loop is more convenient while iterating through method return statement. So here you can use for loop. There is no wrong on usage of the for loop, but it is not a convenient. No variable is managing, only method return value. Next method returning a boolean value. So as long as records are there, next method will be keep returning. Next method keep returning boolean. Keep returning boolean. Compilation and running both are success. Copy the same program. Everybody. Only small changes. You can specify column name or column number. So instead of column name, you can specify column number to the getter methods. Select start from person. Whatever records are there in the person, all are returning to the result set. In the result set, cursor will be on top of the first record. While calling RS.next method, cursor will be coming to the first record. If first record is available, it returns a true. If it is returning true, read the first record, first column, second column, third column. Then again call RS.next. It will go to the second record. If record is available, then it is returning true. In the second record, read first column, second column, third column. Again, put the RS.next, third record. In the third record, call first, second, third, RS.next. Call first, second, third. As long as records available, cursor is keep moving and returning a true. Whenever records are not available, it returns false. Same output you will be getting. Copy the same program. Every column data type you can read in the form of a string. Every column data type can read in the form of a string. Every column data type you can read in the form of a string. Any type of the column we can read in the form of a string. Get string method applied for any type of the column. Copy the string. Check it out, the change in the select command. So reading only two columns, try to read only two columns, from every row only two columns. Copy the same. So we are providing aliasing names for IDP underscore ID, for age person underscore age. While specifying column names, you have to provide aliasing names only. In the result set, only aliasing names will be available. You can compile and run. Anyhow, here we are not providing column names, we are providing column numbers. Copy the same program. So here, if you are providing a ID and age while calling getter method, you should not provide ID and age. If you provide ID and age, you will be getting getter. Body, copy the same program.
Thank you.
So result set metadata, it will be extracting metadata of the result set. Whatever metadata is there in the result set, the complete metadata extracting into result set metadata. Then you can call get column count, column name 1, column name 2. Metadata is nothing but columns information, total number of columns, column names, column data types, total number of columns, column names, column data types. Now, guys, everybody, read the data from a table without specifying column names. You only should develop. You should not hard code anywhere column names. You have to develop a program which has to read the data from a table. Even that table also you can supply through scanner or command line arguments. Program should be 100% dynamic. Program has to read a table name from the scanner. Please observe. Program has to read table name through scanner. Then inside that table, whatever columns, whatever rows are there, all has to be. Try to develop by yourself. Table name read from the scanner. Yesterday itself we have seen how to read them. Whatever table you wanted, you can enter the table name through scanner. Program has to read the table name. From that table, it has to read every record from the database and it has to read. Try. Your program should get only table name from you. That too dynamically while running the program through scanner. Program reading table name from the scanner, then interacting with the database, going into that particular table, reading all the records, printing the records. You can develop, only the thing is it in seriousness. Thank you.
developing this, we won't allow JEC classes.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Understood everybody? Very difficult, you know. You can supply dynamically any table. Inside the table, whatever total number of columns. So while loop is for row wise iteration, for loop is for column wise iteration. Here variable is managing, for loop is more advisable. Total number of columns we are coming to know through set metadata, result set metadata. Understood? Any difficulty? Select star from specified table. Get the result set. Get the result set metadata. Get the total number of columns. Row wise iteration. In that particular row, column wise iteration. Get swing of 1. Get swing of 2. Get swing of 3. Three columns are there. For every column, we can use generic getString method. We don't require to worry what is the column name and even what is the column data type. Total number of columns we are coming to know. This is very, very important. Randomly, you can supply any table name. Inside the table, whatever rows, in every row, whatever column, All are reading or not?
There is a way of finding out the total number of columns. There is a way of finding out the total number of columns.
Copy the previous program. Same program, we are just simply adding one more for loop before while loop.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
It's more meaningful way of displaying the data. Yes or no? Whatever table name you are giving, going into the table, reading the columns and putting the columns in the header, then afterwards reading the data and displaying the data. In general, in any project, we will be developing like this only. While showing the data from any existing table, you have to print all the column names, then separate it, then remind. So this is different approach. Enough for today. Practice very well. We'll continue tomorrow.